Hey guys, how you guys doing? It's Sunday, November 26th. I'm back after a 3 to 4 day little vacation. It's a holiday week here in America, celebrating Thanksgiving. So blessings to you and your family. I hope you guys had a wonderful time, but now it's time to talk about the news that should matter to you guys. One of the main things I want to talk about, main bullet points we're going to talk about is first and frontly, the Middle East and what's going on. At this point, Israel has come out in a new report, and they are stating that they are going to destroy any Iranian positions within Syria as close as 40 kilometers to the Syrian-Israeli border. All right, and we, you know, this isn't really anything new, to be honest. All right, we know Israel has taken shots at Syria. We know Israel has conducted airstrikes in Syria. There's been reports, you know, that Israel has already taken shots at Iranian positions in Syria at this point. But the broader picture for all of this, and what's going on in Syria, you know, Syria. Assad and Putin came out and claimed victory. The Syrian civil war was close to an end, you know, but the problem is a greater war after this war may actually loom. And the reason we're talking about this is because of the Iranian positions that are currently in Syria. And not just the Iranian positions, but we're also talking about the U.S. positions. The Pentagon is kind of in a pickle right now. Everyone's losing their mind because of the amount of manpower that we have in Syria currently. The U.S. seems to be building bases up in Syria, and the Pentagon let out there was something around 500 soldiers, 500 military members from the United States in Syria. It was a limit that was placed in by Barack Obama. But now we're learning that there may be thousands of U.S. military members in Syria at this point, building up bases. And you gotta ask yourself why. You know, why is this happening? We've heard from Nikki Haley coming out and saying that, you know, Assad with his chemical weapons use, quote unquote, we all know that Assad didn't really use chemical weapons. Most likely it was rebels, and it's being put on Assad and his regime. But basically, at this point, Nikki Haley hinted that the U.S. may go in alone into Syria if need be. All while Assad and Putin are meeting, saying, you know, they're claiming victory, that the civil war is almost over. The whole situation between Israel, Saudi Arabia, the United States, and Iran is extremely concerning, something we're going to have to continue to watch, guys, because the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia, who at any day now is supposed to take over his father and become king himself, he just does not like Iran. He's the one who said that, you know, came out and said that the rocket fired from Yemen to Saudi Arabia was Iranian, and then the U.S. backed him in that claim. Something else we need to talk about is Russia and how Russia has thousands of troops and hundreds of tanks pouring into eastern Ukraine at this point. And that's a situation that has been going on for years now. You know, it's been going on for years. The mainstream media doesn't really talk about it anymore. After the whole, Crimea situation and what happened there, it was a real hotbed topic for months in the mainstream media, but now no one's talking about it. It's still going on. That war that's in eastern Ukraine, that hasn't gone away. They've had several ceasefires that have broken down, have not worked at all, and it seems at this point, Russia is sending in troops into eastern Ukraine, so that's something also we're going to have to watch. And lastly, what I want to talk about is North Korea. North Korea coming out and stating that the U.S. and Japan are going to disappear off the map. You know, they always come out with this strong rhetoric. We've got experts stating that in December we may actually see a provocation from North Korea. We haven't seen one in quite some time, guys, but it's something we need to keep our eyes open for. After the situation with the defector from North Korea, we saw Kim Jong-un completely replace the personnel on the DMZ. He's been building trenches. He has a new security chief in North Korea. North Korea may be on the brink at this point. You know, this is a situation that's extremely volatile. You know, a mishap, an accident, a false flag may occur and cause a war between the United States, South Korea, Japan, and North Korea. We're seeing China put their nuclear bombers on 24/7 alert because of this whole entire situation. Just at this point, guys, we're waiting for something to occur because a peaceful solution is not going to be attained at this point. We've seen to go through every channel we can for a peaceful solution, and we have not seen one thus yet. So it's something we're going to have to continue to watch, guys. When more information about North Korea, the Middle East, Russia, NATO comes out, I'll let you guys know. We'll talk about it. We'll discuss it. It's Sunday. Have a few beers. Say a few prayers, because the world needs them. And as always, keep your eyes to the skies. Thanks, guys.